In polycythemia vera, or PV, JAK2 mutations lead to uncontrolled red blood cell production, which elevates the hematocrit above the target level of 45%. High red blood cell counts can lead to sludging in blood vessels, causing serious symptoms, and arterial and venous thrombotic complications. PV also causes iron deficiency, because high red blood cell production consumes iron stores. Iron deficiency can lead to extreme fatigue, cognitive impairment, and shortness of breath, impacting patients' quality of life. Although phlebotomy is the most commonly used treatment for PV, this direct removal of red blood cells from the body often exacerbates disease-related iron deficiency, making symptoms more severe. Phlebotomy can also cause significant volume shifts that can lead to low blood pressure, lightheadedness, and dizziness. Cytoreductives are also utilized as treatment for PV, but they do not target red blood cell production alone. Therefore, they often have suboptimal efficacy and may have significant safety issues. Although the goal of all PV treatments is to maintain the hematocrit at less than 45%, many patients require repeated phlebotomies and/or additional therapies because the hematocrit persistently rises above the target threshold, increasing symptoms and the risk of thrombotic events. Is it possible to control the hematocrit more effectively and consistently without worsening iron deficiency? Rusfertide is an investigational novel therapeutic approach to PV that may have the potential to normalize red blood cell production while potentially reducing PV-related symptoms that are common with other treatments. To understand how rusfertide works, we need to understand how iron is distributed, stored, and transported. In the spleen, iron is stored inside macrophages, which recycle iron from senescent red blood cells. Iron gets out of macrophages through an iron transport channel called ferroportin. It's then transported to the bone marrow for erythropoiesis. The more ferroportin channels there are, the more iron is transported into the bloodstream. Iron transport is tightly regulated by an endogenous natural molecule called hepcidin. Hepcidin reduces iron transport by altering the function of ferroportin in two ways: by reducing the number of ferroportin channels on the cell surface, and by physically blocking iron export from macrophages. Can we pharmacologically mimic the action of hepcidin to reduce red blood cell production and the hematocrit? That is what rusfertide does to consistently maintain hematocrit levels below 45%, as shown in ongoing clinical studies. Like hepcidin, rusfertide decreases the function of ferroportin channels on macrophages, decreasing iron transport, decreasing red blood cell production, and normalizing the hematocrit. Iron is not removed from the body. Instead, it is redistributed away from the bone marrow to the macrophages. More iron is stored in macrophages, which alleviates iron deficiency, but less iron is available for red blood cell production. In summary, rusfertide is an investigational therapy for people with PV. By mimicking the action of the endogenous hormone hepcidin, rusfertide may enable consistent control of the hematocrit to less than 45%, while improving iron stores and reducing PV-related symptoms. Protagonist Therapeutics is dedicated to developing treatments for polycythemia vera.